The hardest thing really was the Brown Act. So the Brown Act is that a majority of, there's many aspects to the Brown Act, but it's the sunshine laws. So you can't have, you know, backroom deals. So none of us want backroom deals. So this is kind of funny. Basically, out of five people, let's say the five of us run a city council, only two of us can talk outside of a publicly noticed meeting about any particular topic. And that means, like, I can't talk with Erica one day and then go talk with Mariam the other day. No, can't do that. So if you ever see us come to a meeting and you think, don't these people ever talk? No, we don't. We absolutely don't. So it can be somewhat lonely, and it can also be frustrating because it slows down the process. I get why it's there, but that I think was the biggest challenge.
As someone who likes to talk things out and figure out why you want to think this, why you want to think that, with the camera on and the radio on, et cetera, you can't exactly have the kind of conversation you would have over a cup of coffee or a glass of wine with someone on the dais. It doesn't work the same. It's very stilted, and it's a difficult conversation. I remember there was an individual came up to the public comment and said everything with the dots and commas and therefore there and changing ergo, because we had to create the main five goals all in public, like you would with a rough draft and striking things out all verbally in front of everyone. And it was the weirdest concept. But the other part about that has been how slow we really can get things done. And that is really, really frustrating for me, because I want to run, I want to get things done. And there are ways, and for me being the new one, I'm learning the different ways to get through things, but truly, the agendas are planned out. I mean, we have a lot of things on the agenda over the next few months, and so the next time a new thing can come on can sometimes be 4 or 5 months later, and there has to be a lot of research behind it before it jumps onto the agenda. And even if you have a study session in between all that time, you can't do anything about it. So that part has been a little challenging for me, and I just wish that we could run a little faster.
The Brown Act is challenging. I completely understand why it's there. But coming out of corporate America, you sit together at a table, and some of it happens on a golf course, and you come up with solutions, and you debate, and you get things accomplished. And you can't do that in government like that. You can only talk to one other member of your board so that you're not talking to a majority, in our case, five. So usually if there's something that's really important to me, I'll look at the other four members of the board, and I'll think, okay, who can I align with that will support me on this issue? And that's not good, because you want to get everybody to buy in. So I completely see why it's there, so no backroom deals are cut, but it makes it hard. And it makes it, I think, a little bit more contentious, because then what the public sees is us up here arguing for the first time about something where all of that could have been worked out behind the scenes beforehand. So, and then what Erica said too, it's painstakingly slow to get things through government, where in private enterprise it can happen right away, because time is money. And we forget time is money with us, but it's taxpayers' money.
I think also for me, just separating yourself from the job sometimes, like I used to be in the corporate world. I was a corporate litigator. I fought 3 years over a Kmart parking lot. None of my clients are here, but when I went home at night, I didn't really stress about that Kmart parking lot like that much, and unless you worked for Kmart, like nobody knew about it. Now, we have this issue going on in my neighborhood where certain people who disagree, they have signs in front of their houses. And so it's like, I'm driving up the street, I'm like, this neighbor's probably mad at me. This neighbor's probably really mad at me. So it's hard. You can't really take yourself or separate yourself away. And I think it's a very valid point about things with your kids, because I'll be trying to watch my kid's soccer game and someone's talking to me about the electrical wires over their house. And I'm like, okay. So sometimes even when you're there, you're a little bit not there. But I think with a lot of the people in this room probably being small business owners, it's like you just have that care. It's like your baby, your business. And so it's kind of always on your mind. But it's just a little bit different when it's public, and just finding ways to carve out that space to recharge. Because when you are going through something controversial, I do care about this job. I probably care more than I should. And I take it to heart, and I take it home with me, and I take it to bed with me, and I dream about it. And so it's to separate is truly difficult.